Azure Hybrid Benefit for Windows Server allows you to use your on-premises Windows Server licenses and run Windows virtual machines in Azure at a reduced cost. You can use your licenses for Windows Server 2008 R2, Windows Server 2012, 2012 R2, and Windows Server 2016. The Azure Hybrid Benefit for Windows Server is applicable to Windows Server Standard and Data Center editions, as well as other versions obtained via custom images. With Azure Hybrid Benefit for Windows Server, you can save up to 49% on Windows Server virtual machines by paying only the base compute rates, adding value to your software assurance investments. And if you combine this benefit with Azure Reserved Instances, you can save up to 80% in total. Azure Hybrid Benefit makes Azure the most cost-effective cloud destination for your Windows Server virtual machines. And this benefit is available across all Azure regions. In this video, we'll look at how to use the Azure portal to enable the Azure Hybrid Benefit for Windows Server on new and existing Azure virtual machines. And then we'll look at how to use PowerShell to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit across multiple virtual machines at once. So let's take a look at how to use the Azure portal to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit on a new virtual machine. I go through the normal process of creating a Windows virtual machine. I'm going to use Windows Server 2016, but again, it can be any version from 2008 R2. When I start to create that virtual machine, I fill out the fields, and you'll notice there's a section here at the bottom that asks you if you already have a Windows license. Go ahead and say yes, confirm it, and that's it. As you complete creating the virtual machine, it will automatically add that Azure Hybrid Benefit to the virtual machine. That's the process for enabling Azure Hybrid Benefit on a new virtual machine from the Azure Marketplace. Now, let's say you've brought a virtual machine from on-prem or from another provider. The process for enabling Azure Hybrid Benefit is very much the same. Let's go to my set of images. Now, I've already uploaded an image from my on-premises servers into Azure, a virtual machine image. And now I want to create a new virtual machine in Azure from that image, but I want to still use the Azure Hybrid Benefit. I find the image in the list of images, and I say, I want to create a VM from this image. And again, the system will come up with the Create Virtual Machine wizard. I'll fill out the forms, and I will also have this section here that says, do I already have a Windows license? I say yes. I tell it whether or not it's Windows Server or Windows Client, and that will enable Azure Hybrid Benefit on that new virtual machine that you've brought from on-premises. You can also use the Azure portal to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit on VMs that you already have running in Azure. In this screen, I have a list of virtual machines in the subscription. I want to find out which virtual machines have Azure Hybrid Benefit enabled and which do not. Let's edit the columns that are visible, and let's expose the Azure Hybrid Benefit column. That allows me to quickly see that none of the Windows virtual machines in this subscription have Azure Hybrid Benefit applied to them. Let's go ahead and turn it on one of these virtual machines. I'm going to click to see the details on one of my virtual machines and go to the Configuration tab. The Configuration tab has the option to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit for that particular virtual machine. I'll say yes. Confirm that I have the appropriate licenses available through my software assurance and hit save. Once the system has successfully enabled Azure Hybrid Benefit, I should be able to go back to my list and see that indeed, yes, Azure Hybrid Benefit has been applied to that virtual machine. We use the Azure portal to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit on virtual machines individually. But it's helpful to use something like PowerShell or some other scripting language to enable Azure Hybrid Benefit across many virtual machines at once. I'm going to open the Azure Cloud Shell. Now, the Azure Cloud Shell opens up a PowerShell or Bash session inside the Azure portal. But of course, you can also use your local PowerShell session as well. We're first going to tell PowerShell which subscription we want to do work on. Let's see how we'll use PowerShell to see which virtual machines have Azure Hybrid Benefit enabled and which do not. This command says, for this subscription, let's look at all the virtual machines where the operating system is Windows and the license type is not Windows Server. It does not have the Azure Hybrid Benefit applied. And you'll see it came back and said, here are the four virtual machines in this subscription that do not. And of course, that matches what we see in the portal. Now that we see which virtual machines do not have Azure Hybrid Benefit applied, we can write a script to enable it on all those virtual machines. This bit of PowerShell here says, for each virtual machine that does not have Azure Hybrid Benefit applied, go ahead and set the license type to Windows Server and update the virtual machine to apply it. There we go. Once that command has completed, you'll see that the Azure Hybrid Benefit has been applied to all the applicable machines in that subscription. And of course, we can refresh the Azure portal and see the changes that have been applied there as well. Visit this URL to learn more about Azure Hybrid Benefit for Windows Server and how to enable it in your subscription. Thank you.